Good morning, everyone. The Mike Fink restaurant didn't move far, but for the first time in decades, is not on the Covington shoreline.
BB Riverboats hauled the 77-year-old stern wheeler to its compound in Newport just yesterday afternoon. But the permanent home of the famous boat/restaurant is still up in the air. Local 12's Joe Webb's been following the story, joins us live with the options facing the Mike Fink. Joe, what are they?
Well, we'll get to that in just a minute, Kit. You know, regardless of what you thought about the Mike Fink, it was a fixture on the Covington Riverfront, and the view just really doesn't seem quite right. Something seems missing. That water you see behind me, that's in the Mike Fink, or what used to be the Mike Fink parking lot. But there is some hope that it will be back. And even if it doesn't come back, the Bernstein family, which has owned the boat for years, does have some options. At the intersection of Riverside and Ben Bernstein Place, there's no sign a famous old boat once docked here. The classic view of downtown is just for the birds now. Mike Fink is 1,000 yards upriver, tucked in behind its brothers at BB Riverboats in Newport. For some locals, the parting was sweet sorrow. For others, good riddance.
We would come down and feed the birds, and it was kind of like you'd always see somebody down here and looking at the boat or something, and it was kind of nice.
I think it looks much better without the Mike Fink. I think it looked a little run down and just it looks cleaner, neater now.
Closed since 2008, the Bernstein family had run out of options for the Mike Fink in Covington. The city said it had to go by the first of the year. Yesterday was the first day weather permitted it. Captain Alan Bernstein was at the helm of the tow that moved the boat his dad bought 37 years ago.
Well, it was sad. The boat has been there since the middle 60s.
Today, crews were securing the Mike Fink, stringing power lines, and getting ready to clean it. Bernstein says the future of the Mike Fink is uncertain, but there are three possible options.
Certainly, it could go back to Covington as a restaurant.
The city of Covington says the door is open for a return, but there are some serious details to work out. The biggest problem is an eroding riverbank that is expensive to fix. Another option is keeping it where it is and giving it a new use.
Sure would be to put our offices and infrastructure on the Mike Fink and get rid of some of these other barges,
including the original Crockett's. Bernstein says the last option is the least likely.
So the levee is talking to us about doing some things with the levee and making it a part of that development.
Whatever happens to the old boat, it won't happen immediately, but it has a 5-year-old hull and is good to go for a long time to come. And now the city of Covington has to figure out what to do with this space. It's currently doing a study that could answer some of the questions about how to stabilize the riverbank. The city knows that that will take a lot of money, and because this location is directly downstream from where the Licking River dumps into the Ohio, it creates all sorts of problems here. So this really wasn't a particularly good location for a floating restaurant to begin with, but if they fix it and if the boat gets fixed, they say the door is open for it to come back. But don't know when that or if that might happen. Kit?
Yeah, thank you, Joe. And several attempts to get the Mike Fink reopened failed because of lack of financing. The restaurant originally closed 5 years ago when it was moved upriver to get that new hull. A planned $1.5 million renovation of the interior was never done. Well, one